Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of WAMP server on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how to write a Hello World PHP program and how to run that with the help of our WAMP server on our browser. So to watch the video till the end, I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you're still facing any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there. You can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install WAMP server, you need to first download it. So for that, just simply go to favorite browser and to search over here, WAMP server download. Hit enter. So that will show you this wampserver.com. So just simply go to their official site of WAMP server. Here it is, scroll down and you will see this WAMP server 64-bit version 3.3.7. So just simply click on this button. So that will show you this pop-up. So you need to click on this, you can download it directly. So that will show you this source fortnet here of WAMP server will get downloaded within 5 seconds. So you can see it is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our WAMP server is already been downloaded over here. So to install, just simply double click on this installer. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and it's going to show you this language. So here you need to select your own language and click on OK. So that's going to show you this license agreement. Accept it and click on next. So here also click on next. And now we can see that it is showing some error. So what it is showing is that it is telling basically all these packages are missing. So starting with Visual C++ 2012, x86 is what I'm not having on my system. Then this 2010 SP1 and 2012 x64. Alright. So it has also given a URL. So it is telling to go to this website, and then you need to download all this package and then you need to install it. So on your system, it might be showing lot of other libraries that are missing, right? So lot of other packages. So whichever package is missing, you need to download that. Let's first go to this WAMP server, aviotechno.net. So go to your browser again, open a new tab and just simply type WAMP server, aviotechno. Just, you know, go to their official site. So this link also I'm going to provide on our description. So here if you scroll down, you will see, you have to scroll down till bottom, you will see all these different packages are available, right? So these are all 32-bit and these are all 64-bit. So you need to, you know, go to your error message. So you need to check which package is missing. So Visual C++ 2012 x86. So Visual C++ 2012 x86. So this is what it is missing. So you need to download, click on that, and it's going to start downloading. So one by one you need to download all missing packages. So I have downloaded the first one. Next we need to download, you know, Visual C++ 2010 SP1, and this time remember it is x64. All right so you need to go to under x64 and 2010 SP1, so this one. So click on that and download it. So that one is also downloaded. Similar way, you need to download Visual C++ 2012 x64. So 2012 x64, so this one. So you need to download all the packages that are missing on your system. All right so in my case it is showing only 3. In your system it might be showing 5 or 6 or even 1 or 2. All right so you understood the point, right? So you need to download these missing packages from here, so from this list. After downloading, just go to your download directory. You need to first click on OK and cancel this installation, okay, for the time being. And now go to your download directory. So so these 3 are the missing packages. We need to install it one by one. So start with the first one, access the license agreement, install, click on yes to provide administrative privileges, and it is done. Click on close. Similar way, install the next one, click on yes, install it, access the license agreement, click on install, and it is done as well. So yeah, click on finish. So next, the third one, just double click on it, access the license agreement, install. It will ask you for administrative privileges, click on yes, and this is also done. So yeah, click on close. Right. So in this way, you need to, you know, install all missing packages first. when it is done, let's install our WAMP server all over again. So double click on the installer. It's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and you are getting that same language window. Just simply click on OK. So license agreement accepted. Click on next, again next. This time you see it is no longer showing any error, right? Because we have installed all missing packages. So you need to do that same thing. So once you do that, once you install all missing packages, you're good to go. You're good to install WAMP server. So here, keep it default, click on next. So preparing to install, and our installation is actually begun. So it's going to take some time. Let's minimize our download directory first. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you to subscribe to our channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of videos. You can see, you can watch all these different videos, Angular, PyCharm, Eclipse ID, and also WordPress tutorial as well. So I am posting lot of videos on WordPress. So some videos are 1 hour, some videos are, you know, 30 minute video. So you can watch this playlist. So this playlist will have lots of videos on WordPress. So as you know that WordPress is actually developed on PHP, and we are also installing WAMP server, which is actually a PHP server. So you know, if you want, you can learn WordPress also. So that's going to really, you know, give you a very good skill to have. So yeah, so here let's wait for some time. Special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our WAMP server is almost installed. Before that, it is asking to select a default browser. So it's going to use Edge as a default browser. You can change it to Chrome also, totally fine. I'll keep on yes for the time being and click on open. So that is done. Next, I'm going to also keep it same for Notepad. So same also I'm going to do. I'm going to click on yes and click on open. So we are going to keep default Notepad and our Microsoft Edge as a default browser and text editor. Alright, you can change it later also, totally fine. Just no need to worry about that. And it is rightly installed. So click on next and click on finish. So our WAMP server is now rightly installed. Just simply double click on the shortcut. It's going to ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes. And soon it's going to start our WAMP server. So start of services, be patient. And you can see it is showing we are ready, all services are running. So if you click on this icon, you can see this WAMP server is green now. All right so usually when it starts, it starts with orange and then it turns to green. All right so yeah, so you can see this color is green, so our all services are running. So you are good to start with our PHP program. So go to the C folder and go to WAMP 64 folder over here. So just go inside that folder. You will see all these different files and folders over here. You need to go inside this WWW folder and you need to create your PHP files over here or your PHP projects over here. So I'll start with creating a new folder. So right click and create a new folder, and let's name this folder as PHP workspace. All right just go inside that folder, and here let's create a text document, and let's give the text document name as hello world.php. All right hit enter. So that will show you whether you like to change the file name extension. Yes. So if you are unable to see this type of file name extensions, all you need to do is you need to hover over view, to hover over show, and then you need to enable this file name extensions. All right so once you have this enabled, so you have a tick mark icon, you will see this type of file name extensions over here. So now I'll write a simple hello world PHP code snippet. So I'll right click and open it in a Notepad, and I'll just write a simple hello world PHP code snippet. So I'll give angular bracket, close that angular bracket, and I'll just simply do echo hello world. All right hello world. Just go to file and save this file, and after that just simply go to your browser and just open a new tab and just simply type localhost and give a slash, and then it provide this exact folder name, which is php space workspace. Alright, just copy this folder, go directory back and right click and copy this folder and just go to your browser and just simply right click and paste that folder path over here. Hit enter. So that's going to immediately show you this index or PHP workspace folder. So whatever you have created within PHP workspace folder, so we have a file called hello world. So that is what it is showing over here, right? Now only thing that is left to do is to just click on this file. So click on that and immediately you are getting the output, right? So whatever you have written over here, so that output is coming properly. So let's say you are changing this hello world to hello everyone, and you are going to file and saving this file, and now if you are just simply refreshing it, you are getting the output hello everyone, right, coming on our browser. So in this way you can easily install WAMP server, you can start working on your PHP projects with the help of WAMP server. Don't forget to watch my other PHP videos. So I've created a video on how to use Visual Studio Code for PHP, so you can watch that video as well. And also if you're interested, you can watch my other WordPress videos as well. So some videos are 1 hour, some are 1 hour 30 minute video. I can guarantee if you are watching this video, you'll be able to learn a lot of new things about WordPress. Alright, so how to build an entire website from scratch. So watch these videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.